The road is long, with a many a winding tongue that leads us to who knows where.
Hello, Jack.
Hello there, sir. How are you?
Hey, how was the mother?
Not a bother on her. We're down at Mrs. Wright's funeral. And you wouldn't know who you'd see in around here, you know.
John
was a gentleman.
John, you're taking out what's out now.
That's right. John left me everything he had, and I never got a light. Mrs. Carthy, he had a joint account with Mrs. Carthy.
Oh, Mrs. Carthy the Hill?
Yeah. And the solicitor wrote to me and he said, Jack, you're a lucky man. John Carthy left you lock, stock and barrel. So I went up to Mrs. Carthy and showed her the will.
Yeah.
And told her that I didn't want to cause any problems. She thought it was entitled, it was all right, but if she thought it wasn't, it was all right too. Or she said, Jack, John thought a lot of you. And she said, he'd want you to have it and you'd get it. But in a month after, she sent for me and she said that she believed John wasn't of a sound mind. But I needn't tell you, I wasn't going to do anything in an old woman. Never got a life.
Would that be John or Larry?
John.
John.
John owned the house.
That's right.
And he's a few thousand. No, he's a few thousand, but you know, Johnny's account.
Oh, I see.
So there you are. Now, what is this thing doing? Can you listen to me talking or not?
No, that doesn't that'd be big money.
The last time I was going to jail, the cameraman, he didn't wake up for 3 weeks.
He let the jars hang.
I let the jars hang. Yeah.
I'll take a couple of steps backwards.
Oh, yeah.
Well,
listen,
I've met on the whole job.
That's just great to be.
No, you're a busy man.
Every morning. But not now. I want to get up now to half six. To be out.